If you have clicked on this video, it is exactly because we need to be having this conversation. You need to be having this conversation because you need this information. You've been diagnosed with osteoarthritis of the hip, and usually when you get that diagnosis, there's an automatic recommendation for a hip replacement, which is massively traumatic surgery. I'm going to tell you unequivocally that that might not be necessary. Welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I'm a sports coach. And I had hip osteoarthritis to the point that I was barely functional and I was told I needed a hip replacement. You may have seen my previous video on this from about a year and a half ago. If not, I'll link it down here. Anyway, I embarked on a different journey to try to see if I could recover without having surgery. Not because I made this up, but because I'd heard about it enough times, so I tried it for myself. And you know what? It worked. I'm running again, I'm riding my bicycle, I'm perfectly active and mobile and pain-free, and my hip cartilage has recovered. I have x-rays to show it has recovered. All it takes is proper nutrition, proper weight management, proper lifestyle choices, and the appropriate exercises to rehabilitate the hip area while not doing the exercises that make it worse. So this is something you can do at home. It might take a year, but within 3 months you'll know if it's working or not. So it's not a big deal. Delay the surgery at least 3 months and do these things to make yourself better, or to try and get better, because in 80% of cases you will recover. Now, of course, it's not going to work for everybody because it depends how bad your damage is and how long you've been suffering from it. And it may be that you really do need a hip replacement. Well, why don't you find out? Why don't you take the 3 months to do these things, eat properly, exercise properly, rest properly, stop poisoning your body with food that causes inflammation and interferes with the healing process, and give yourself every chance to do this naturally and be better again. I'm running again. I'm running 10 miles in the mountains. I could hardly walk before. So for it to not be able to heal, it really has to be really bad. And in most cases, it's not that bad. So do this. I'm going to attach a playlist here of videos that I've done that will cover things like nutrition and rehabilitation exercises, and why you should eat certain things, and very importantly, why you should cut certain things from your diet. And you could go to my website, shapefixer.com, and you'll see a lot of information there. There's also a course available if you want additional focus on very specific actions to take and more exercises, but you can manage this yourself. This is absolutely something you can do yourself. You just need the information. Now, I have to say, this is not magic, okay? This is not some weird therapy or anything. This is just biology. It's simple biology. It's your metabolism, your physiology. It's the biology and the biochemistry that goes on in your body. And researchers now have discovered more about these processes, and we understand that it works like it does. Not every doctor will know this, because doctors are not necessarily always up to date with all the research in every single aspect of health management, because they can't be expected to. It's impossible. So some of them know, some of them don't. It's not their speciality. So I'm not blaming your doctor for saying you need a hip replacement. And of course, as I said, maybe you do. But a surgeon is a surgeon, and he does surgery. You need to get an opinion from someone else, or just try this. It's not going to cost you much at all. In fact, just about nothing, because you're going to eat less, so you'll have a smaller grocery bill. But if you eat properly, and again, I say, look at the videos that I'm attaching here, or go to my website and see what it is, how it works, how your hip actually works, understand what constitutes your cartilage, what your hip joint is made of, what's damaged, why it can heal, what foods are going to help you, what foods are going to harm you, what specific exercises are going to help you rebuild your strength around there and support that joint so that it is able to heal. This is absolutely something you can do yourself. Go to my website, look at the course, see if the course is for you. If the course is not for you, that's fine. There's lots of free videos here on YouTube. Just have a look at my playlist and let me know how it goes. But trust yourself, trust your body. Your body knows how to heal. You just have to allow it to do that. And your chances are really, really good. And what's the worst that can happen? You try this for 3 months and you don't get any better. Okay. It's no worse than you are now. At least then you know. And then you're making the right decision if you do need to go and have surgery. So all the best with that. Thank you for your time. And put your comments down below. And if you have done this, please let us know how it goes. It's wonderful to hear back from people who have been able to cure themselves and heal themselves and get better.